I'm Katrina Zurich, reporting with TVR Media. I'm here at the airport where they are processing the Ukrainian refugees. So I'm going to be doing some interviews with some of the Ukrainian refugees and finding out what they need. Secondly, we have a relief fund called ICAN Relief. And so through our relief fund, we send reliefs and we work with people on the grounds whenever there's like natural disasters and fires and tornadoes and hurricanes and also war. So we are collecting money right now through the relief fund to help the refugees coming here to Czech Republic. So another reason we're here at the airport where they're processing the refugees is to interview them and find out what their needs are and how we can help. So more than likely we'll be purchasing groceries and blankets and baby items and medicine, things that people need when they leave their houses and come running to a different country and don't have probably clothes. Our relief fund is icanrelief.org. If you want to donate to help with that, you can donate at icanrelief.org. And let's get started. Hi, I'm Katrina with TVR Media, and we are here at the airport in České Budějovice where they are processing Ukrainian refugees. And I am here with
Elizabeth.
So this is Elizabeth, and she was gracious enough to do an interview for you guys. And so we're just wondering, where did you come from?
I come from Kyiv.
Kyiv?
Apparently.
Okay, and how did you manage to get here?
It's a difficult way. It's starting from one volunteer who helped me to go to the vokzal.
Okay.
And when we go, all roads will be closed. After us.
Okay.
And
yeah.
When I go to the vokzal and sit in the train.
Train?
Mm-hmm. My train, evacuation train. And when it arrives, vokzal light is off in vokzal.
Okay.
And I go evacuated to Zaporizhia.
Okay.
And there I live few days in my sister, and go to the Slovakia.
Okay, Slovakia.
And in Cordon, Slovakia, I meet two Czechs,
people.
And they told. They helped me to go to the Praga, and from Praga, Czechs,
yes,
departed me to this place.
Mm-hmm.
And
by car.
Yes.
Okay. So when did you leave your home?
What?
When did you leave your home? Like a week ago?
Like a week ago.
About a week ago?
Yes.
So you've been traveling for a whole week. And so do you know where you're going to stay now that you're here?
Yes. They gave me a home,
okay.
New home, where I can live, eat, and sleep.
Okay. And you are alone or with others?
No, I'm alone.
Okay. And did they give you a job or...?
I can take a job, but I need to take a promotion
okay.
for a job. Now I can't, because I can't. I haven't propositions.
You haven't what?
I haven't people who won't give me job.
Okay. So you have no job offers, but you can take a job.
Yes.
But nobody's offered you a job yet.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you have any family still in Ukraine?
Yes, I still have some sisters, mother, and grandparents in Ukraine.
Do you think they will come here to join you?
No, they don't join me.
No, okay. All right, well, thank you so much for the information. Is there anything that you need that we could help you with?
No, thanks.
No? Is there anything you would like to say to Americans?
Yes, thanks for helping.
All right, well, thank you so much for the interview. It was nice talking to you. To watch more informative videos, subscribe to our channel or go to www.tvr.media. To help the Ukrainian refugees, please visit www.icanrelief.org.